Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys my curly hair routine. I'm going to be showing you from shampooing all the way to styling to this end, to these results. If you are interested in seeing what products I use to get this touchable curls, then go ahead and please keep watching. Jumping right in, I decided to bring you guys in my shower today and show you guys, you know, my current shampoo and conditioner situation. I only shampoo my hair once or twice a week. I try not to actually shampoo it often. I do cold wash it, which is when you only use conditioner. So here I had worn my hair straight for about a week, and it was actually my last time I'm gonna wear it straight for a while. I'm trying to take a break, see how long I can go. Make sure your hair is super wet, completely saturated with water before going in with shampoo. I've been using the Shea Moisture shampoo, and honestly the only reason I've been using it is because I was trying to follow the curly girl method. When I first started trying to wear my natural hair more, I was trying to follow the curly girl method, and this was one of the shampoos that they recommended that doesn't have any of those parabens, silicones, and alcohol, I believe it is. So this is what I'm using right now. I actually really like it. I feel like it cleans my hair really nicely. It has a really good lather. I feel like it stays stuck in my hair though. I have to really work to get it out of my hair because it just like stays in there. My hair is so thick, you guys. I forgot to mention, I have thick hair. So I have thick, full hair. I have a lot. I do go directly into my scalp with the shampoo just to make sure that I get it clean, very, very clean in there. So I like to massage with my fingers, really work it in my whole scalp, all the way from the top of my head all the way to the very bottom behind my ears. Just scrub, 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 make sure it's completely clean. And then I go ahead and rinse that off completely. Next, I'm going to be going in with this Tresemme curling conditioner. I don't know if this one is curly girl approved or not, but I do really like the conditioner, and I'm not necessarily following the curly girl method anymore, so it doesn't really matter to me as long as my hair reacts well to it and my hair looks good. I'm not really too worried about following like a really strict curly girl method thing. All right, so once I'm done shampooing, I'm gonna go in with my conditioner. I like to split my hair in half just to make sure that I get it in there really well. I go from the ends of my hair all the way to the scalp and just generously apply this conditioner. I put a lot of conditioner in my hair, and I'm gonna let it sit while I go ahead and wash the rest of my body. So once I'm already done, you know, washing the rest of my body and it's time to wash the conditioner out, I like to switch the water to a little bit cold. And I do want to apologize, you guys. The lens kept getting so foggy the whole time I was filming. It was getting so foggy. My water was too hot, and the restroom's pretty small, so it's not like enough space to where, you know, it doesn't get foggy. So I was trying my hardest. That's why I decided to sit down and explain to you guys when I was on the shower realizing that the lens was getting so foggy. I was like, okay, I'm gonna have to sit down and talk about, you know, what I'm doing, because it's kind of hard to see at some points. Once I'm done washing the rest of my body and the conditioner has been sitting in my hair for a little bit, I like to run my fingers through it. I still believe in brushes. I still use brushes, but I do like to get some of the tangles out in the shower when I have a lot of conditioner on. I just feel like, you know, the slip, it's so slippery, and it's just much easier to untangle my hair when I have a lot of conditioner in it. Make sure I wash it really good out of my my roots. So I like to switch the water to cold, rinse the conditioner out of my root, but still leaving about 40% of the conditioner in my hair. I like to turn my head upside down and scrunch my hair up as I'm pretty much rinsing the conditioner out. I just feel like it helps my curls get a little bit of volume and just like their shape back. And I go ahead and wrap my hair in a t-shirt. Sometimes I don't even put a t-shirt and I just walk out of the shower with my hair completely dripping. It depends if I'm gonna do my hair right out of the shower, if I'm gonna do my makeup first. I went and did my makeup, and now we're gonna go ahead and move on to the styling part of the video. When I go to style my hair always has to be completely drenched. As you can tell, my hair kind of got dry from when I was doing my makeup. I ended up getting, you know, pretty dry, and this is my hair with no extra product. Moving on to styling, if you get out right of the shower and you still have about, you know, 40% conditioner, you can start this process right away. Or if you're like me and your hair is already, you know, kind of got dry, what I do is I like to put water in a little mister and I put a little bit of conditioner in there, mix it up, and that's how I re-wet my hair. And I like doing my hair by sections, so I like to start at the bottom and move my way up. So I'm gonna go ahead and divide my hair. I'm only doing a small section right now so I can show you guys the products, how I distribute it. But normally I do three sections and that's it. So the first product that I'm gonna be going in with without running my fingers through my hair, just making sure my hair is super wet, like I want it to be dripping a little bit. I'm gonna go in with the Cantu Leave-In Conditioning Repair Cream. So I like to go in with this one because it's just the one that I have. It smells really good and it's been doing great things for my hair, so I'm not gonna question it for now. I like to untangle my hair with this product. This is about how much I take for a section, you know, this big for the whole bottom. I try not to use too much. You don't want to use too much product because too much product is what's going to weigh your curls down. So I try to just use just enough where I rub it into my hands and it's distribute enough to where I can just go through my hair and apply it. I go ahead and apply this and then I take my brush and brush my hair out. Make sure I have no tangles. I feel like this makes it easy to brush my hair. And I'm still making sure that my hair is completely wet. You don't want any dry pieces when you're applying any of your curly hair products. You want your hair to be wet. And I'm gonna keep repeating that because I didn't realize how important that part was until I started doing it, and then now I notice a huge difference on how my hair looks. So I go ahead and apply a small amount of this product to my whole hair and untangle it and then scrunch it. So once I'm done applying this Cantu product, head and move on to the Bounce Curl Avocado Rose Oil Clump and Define Cream. It's to soften, hold, and shine curls. So I don't take a huge amount of this because it's kind of expensive. And I feel like you don't need a lot. As you can tell, I took a very small amount. I'll show you guys the whole process of my whole hair routine. So I'm gonna let you guys watch me do the rest of the layers and apply these products, just because I want you guys to see every detail. So I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, run the clip. Like I said, I'm gonna apply first the Cantu Leave-In Conditioner, untangle my hair, make sure it's soaking wet, and then apply the Avocado Rose Oil Clumping Cream. So I'm gonna do that for my whole hair and I'm gonna let you guys watch it. Doing that to my whole hair, now is time for the final step. The final step is going to be me applying this Bounce Curl Light Cream Gel. I'm going to take a pretty good amount of this light cream gel, and I do the same thing, kind of apply it to the outer layer of my hair, mix it into my hands, apply it to the outer layer of my hair, and then scrunch it into my whole hair. I do apply this about twice. I like to really scrunch my hair with this gel, just take my time and just scrunch, scrunch, scrunch. Alright you guys, so moving on, once I am done applying this Bounce Curl Light Cream Gel, I am going to diffuse my hair. So this is one of the main reasons I can't do the Curly Girl method, is because they don't believe in any heat at all, and I just can't with that. I don't have time to be sitting around for like 2 or 3 hours for my hair to air dry. That's just not realistic for me. Pretty much, when I'm scrunching in the light gel, I like to scrunch it until my hair is not dripping wet anymore. And then after that, I'll go in with a t-shirt and I'll scrunch out any extra water that there could be in my hair. So now we're at this step where we have all our products applied to my hair. Here is where you can decide to either just let your hair air dry. If you're gonna let your hair air dry, I would pin up a few pieces, like just like at the root, I would pin up some hairs so that you can have a little bit of volume. This is if you don't have a diffuser, you don't have time, you just wanna run out the door. I've done this before where I apply the products and I just run out the door and my hair looks fine. It just won't have as much volume as if you do it with a diffuser. But it's still gonna look really pretty defined and your curls are gonna look great. I just wanna let you know it is an option to not use a diffuser, but I'm gonna use a diffuser because that is just what I need for my hair. I feel like it looks the best when I use a diffuser. This is my blow dryer, my diffuser. As you can tell, I have tape on it. Ghetto Fabulous. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna try and dry my roots. So I'm just gonna hover over my hair, over my roots, turn my head to the left, all my hair to the left, and dry my roots there. Turn all my hair to the right, dry my roots there. The bottom, turn my head upside down, dry my roots. I think I do that, I don't know, maybe 5 minutes. I wouldn't say I take that long on doing that. So I do that for maybe 5 minutes. And then I do this motion where I go up and down and kind of dry the outside layer of my hair without touching it with the blow dryer. I'm just blow drying it from the outside. And I do that for maybe 2 minutes. So I try not to, even though it's important, that's an important step, I don't do it for as long as I should. After I went over the roots a little bit, and the reason that I do dry my roots is so that if I just go in and diffuse my whole hair and I don't do the roots, then it's gonna be so heavy at the top because it's not gonna be dry at the top, it's gonna be wet and heavy, and then your hair is gonna be all curly at the bottom and it's just not gonna have as much volume. So I do like to go in and dry my roots first a little bit. After that, I turn my head upside down and I just start diffusing with upwards motion. I do like to hold it for a few seconds, let release, move on to the next section, hold it for a few seconds, release, and so on. So I think it takes me 15 minutes to diffuse my hair. So what I do like to do is I like to obviously start with my head upside down and then I do that for a while. And I like to turn my head back normal. That way it's not just drying at the top and it's drying evenly. And I pretty much just keep doing this to my whole hair until I feel like it's 85% dry. So I just keep diffusing it and that's pretty much what I do. I wouldn't say I have a huge technique for how I diffuse my hair. I just try and make sure and give it volume and not just keep my head upside down the whole time. I like to turn my head like this and actually do it so I can give it a little bit more volume. Alright guys, so I had left this part out on accident, but once I'm done diffusing my hair and my hair is dry, I do like to go in and re-scrunch it just to make sure I get any gel cast off of my hair. That gel doesn't really leave me that big of a cast, but if you want soft curls, don't forget this part. Sorry if this voiceover sucks, and back to the regular video. Bye! Alright, so once I'm done diffusing it, then this is the finished product. I have 2 layers in my hair, which is why my hair doesn't have even more volume, is because I have no layers, so all my hair is just sitting at the same length on top of each other. So if I had layers, it would just be more free, more voluminous, and I'm definitely gonna do that. Buying this is, it's pretty pricey, so I am gonna actually look for some drugstore products because I just watched a video and the girl is using Shea Moisture products and I really want to try some of those products. So I'm definitely going to be checking out more Curly Girl products now that I want to wear my hair curly more often because these are kind of expensive. Anyways, you guys, my camera is blinking that it's dying. I'm so happy I got to finish telling you guys my routine, everything I do, and showing you guys the products that I use. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you have any questions, don't be shy. Comment below and I'll comment back to you. And thank you guys so much for watching. If you did like this video, don't forget to give me a big old thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel down below and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye!